Did you know that all four gas planets have asteroid rings? Yeah, although Saturn has the most colorful rings, the four gas giants have rings. But why do only those planets have rings? Why don't rocky planets have? And what would happen if the Earth had rings like Saturn's? Let's find out. Why does Saturn have rings? Before asking ourselves why the Earth does not have beautiful and colorful asteroid rings like Saturn's, we must ask ourselves why Saturn does have asteroid rings. Since the telescope was invented in the 17th century, astronomers have been exploring the universe and discovering its deepest secrets. One celestial object that has long intrigued scientists is the planet Saturn and its famous ring of asteroids. The first person to observe Saturn's rings was the Dutch astronomer Christiaan Huygens in 1655. Huygens could identify Saturn's main ring using a crude telescope. However, it was not known then that it was a ring and was believed to be two large moons orbiting the planet. It was only in 1850 that the British astronomer James Clerk Maxwell proposed that the rings were a series of small particles orbiting the planet. But the proper understanding of how Saturn's asteroid ring formed didn't come until much later. In the 1960s, NASA and Soviet Union space missions began exploring the solar system, particularly the giant planets. The Pioneer 11 spacecraft was the first to reach Saturn in 1979 and was able to take detailed images of the rings. These images revealed that Saturn's asteroid ring comprises many tiny particles from dust to house-sized rocks. But the question was, how was this ring formed? Saturn's asteroid ring is an incredibly complex structure and is believed to have formed from an icy moon orbiting the planet. This moon, known as the parent moon, would have been destroyed about a billion years ago by Saturn's gravity, causing it to break into millions of tiny fragments left in orbit around the planet. The parent moon is believed to have been an icy moon similar to Saturn's moons, such as Enceladus or Mimas. These moons are composed mainly of water, ice, and rock, making them relatively light. The parent moon would have been in an unstable orbit around Saturn due to gravitational interaction with the planet's other moons until Saturn's gravity destroyed it. Finally, the resulting fragments were left in a stable orbit around Saturn. Over time, these fragments collided with each other and fragmented into smaller and smaller particles, creating the asteroid ring we see today. Scientists believe most of the ring is made up of water ice particles, although there are small amounts of rock and dust. Even though we now know how Saturn's asteroid ring formed, many scientists are still trying to understand it. For example, why do rings have different thicknesses and densities in different parts? Why do some rings have such distinctive features, like the Cassini gap? The Cassini gap is one of the most distinctive features of Saturn's asteroid ring. This gap is a relatively empty area in the ring that is believed to have been created by the gravitational influence of Saturn's largest moon, Titan. Titan is believed to exert a substantial gravitational force on the ring particles, pushing them out in a specific area and creating a visible gap without rock or ice fragments. Invisible rings. Although the most colorful asteroid rings in the solar system are those of Saturn, Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune also have rings around them. So why can't these be seen with the naked eye? There are several reasons why seeing the asteroid rings of Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune from Earth is impossible. First, the asteroid rings of these planets are much fainter and less dense than Saturn's ring. Second, the rings of these planets are closer to the planet itself, making them more difficult to distinguish from the planetary background. Also, most telescopes used by amateur and professional astronomers are not powerful enough to distinguish the asteroid rings of these planets from other objects in space. More advanced telescopes, such as the Hubble Space Telescope, have been used to study the asteroid rings of these planets. But even with these tools, the rings are challenging to see, and careful image processing is required to detect them. Another reason it is impossible to see the asteroid rings of Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune from Earth is that these planets have thick atmospheres that can distort light reaching Earth, making it even more challenging to see. But perhaps the most crucial reason the rings of Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune are not visible from Earth is their origin and composition. While Saturn's rings result from the disintegration of an icy moon that generated ice-rich rings, the rings of the other three gas giants formed by gravitational capture. Gravitational capture is a process by which a planet captures an object with its gravity and anchors to it, causing this new object to become part of the planet as a moon or as part of its asteroid ring. This means that the three gas giants were trapping the asteroids and comets that passed nearby for billions of years, forming their rings little by little. For this reason, the rings of these three planets are not as dense and bright as those of Saturn. In addition, many of the asteroids that form the rings of Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune are dark, and that makes it even more challenging to see them. It's likely that if the Earth had a ring like these three gas giants, it would be tough to see even from Earth. Why doesn't the Earth have rings? All this being said, the main reason the four rocky planets don't have rings is because of their gravitational pull. In the case of the gas giants, as they have a lot of mass, the gravitational force of attraction is enormous. And for this reason, all the asteroids, comets, and other bodies that are close to them are trapped by gravity. And little by little, the rings are formed. But Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars don't have that much mass, so it's difficult for them to retain an asteroid ring. Another essential factor to consider is the solar system snow line. The snow line is an imaginary line in the solar system that separates the regions where solid materials freeze and form water ice from the regions where these materials evaporate and remain gaseous. The location of the snow line varies according to the distance from the sun and the local pressure and temperature. Still, it is usually located in the region that separates Mars and Jupiter, that is, in the asteroid belt. In the inner part of the solar system, the snow line is located at about 5 astronomical units AU from the sun. This means that rocky planets such as Earth form from rocky and metallic materials that did not freeze at this distance range. Instead, these planets are mostly made up of silicates and metals. In the outer part of the solar system, beyond the snow line, the temperature and pressure are low enough for water and other volatiles to freeze into ice. This means that the giant planets such as Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune have solid cores made of ice and rock and are surrounded by atmospheres made chiefly of hydrogen, helium, and methane. Saturn's majestic rings have endured to this day because they are beyond the snow line. If they weren't the same distance as Earth, they would have evaporated entirely by now because they are made mostly of ice. This means that if the Earth had an asteroid ring like Saturn's, it would evaporate quickly because it is too close to the sun. So the joy of having rings would not last long. What would happen if, instead of rings like those of Saturn, the Earth had rings like those of Jupiter, Uranus, or Neptune made of rocks and dust? As we mentioned earlier, the ring would be very dark and difficult to see with the naked eye. To be visible enough, it would have to have a lot of asteroid fragments, and the only way to achieve this would be to destroy the moon. Roche limit. Saturn's rings formed when one of its moons passed the Roche limit. But what exactly is the Roche limit? The Roche limit is a critical distance that determines the minimum distance that an object can approach another object without being destroyed by gravitational tidal forces. This distance is essential in studying planetary systems and applies to objects such as natural satellites, planetary rings, and comets. In simple words, the Roche limit is a region around a planet where the gravitational pull is so great that once an object crosses it, if it doesn't have enough speed to get out on its own, will end up being smashed to pieces. This happened to the natural satellite that formed Saturn's rings. Once it entered the Roche limit, it could no longer leave and was destroyed, forming the rings we see today. In the case of the Earth, the Moon is very far from the Roche limit. We also know that the Moon moves away from the Earth by 3 centimeters per year. So it is a guarantee that it will never come close to our planet to form a ring of asteroids. But what if instead of the Moon, it was an asteroid that would exceed the Earth's Roche limit? Suppose a giant asteroid, such as the asteroid Apophis. Imagine that in many years, this asteroid gets so close to Earth that it exceeds the Roche limit and is destroyed by Earth's gravity, turning the asteroid into a ring of asteroids. What effect would something like this cause on the Earth? An asteroid ring would give us an impressive view from anywhere on the planet, especially at night. But beyond the beautiful views that would inspire the verses of many poets, a ring of asteroids around the Earth would not be suitable for us, since it would hinder many tasks that today depend on having a clear sky. One of them is astronomical observation. All the astronomers in the world would suffer depression because a ring of asteroids would reflect too much sunlight and hinder the vision of all the telescopes and observatories. On the other hand, all the telecommunications and tasks involving artificial satellites would be in trouble because many artificial satellites would share space with the asteroid ring. In addition, an asteroid ring would jeopardize the future of space exploration, as spacecraft would have to perform complicated maneuvers to avoid asteroids while trying to escape Earth's gravity. And ultimately, the worst part of having an asteroid ring is that Earth's gravity would pull in most of the asteroids, causing them to fall on the surface from time to time, causing a barrage of meteorites that would decimate all life on Earth. Without a doubt, while they are visually beautiful and put on quite the show, our planet is much better off without an asteroid ring. But don't let this get you down. Earth may not be able to have or need an asteroid ring, but how about an artificial ring around Earth made with human science and technology? That would be much more possible, and unlike an asteroid ring, an artificial ring would benefit humanity. Would you like us to make a video about what would happen if the Earth had an artificial ring? Let us know your opinion in the comments.